Paul McGuire Grimes, KSTP, Minneapolis, St. Paul. Daniel, it is great talking to you today. I'm really enjoying Tehran so far, so kudos to you on making this really edge-of-your-seat show.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Paul. And I see that you have many books, much more books than I do.
Yeah, I mean, it's our whole movie collection that we have. There's some TV shows over there, and then all of this is movies.
Amazing.
Thank you.
Wonderful.
Now, can you talk a little bit about the working relationship with Apple TV? When did they come into the picture with this?
Oh, you know, the relationship with Apple TV is amazing. It's one of the best partnerships. So I would say the best partnership that I had, that we had, especially as Israelis. Apple TV came in when we were in post-production, early post-production. We were in contact with them, and they just loved what they saw, and we've been partners ever since. And it was just an amazing ride with those highly professional people that, you know, bring our show, which is, you know, this exciting thriller about Tehran, to audiences worldwide, which is amazing.
Now, I always love when a story goes in really unexpected directions, and that is certainly happening in Tehran. As you, as the co-creator and director, did you have a lot of this all mapped out in advance, or did that kind of come in the writing room as the episodes were being written?
I'm really happy you're asking me this, because you know, I'm a sort of director that's really involved in writing, and I had the privilege and chance and the great, you know, writers that you know, let me in. Moshe Zonder and Omri Shenhar, and together we kind of chiseled our way through. So, you know, Moshe had his big ideas in the beginning, and then when Omri and I entered the room, we started looking into the small details together, and you find your way, you find your path, looking at the big, you know, the big picture, the big idea at the end. And mostly I would say what we wanted to do is two things. First, to keep the audience involved. You know, it's the kind of series where you always want to withhold information from the audience, and to have them on the edge of their seat. So, you know, that was one job, and that's a thing you do. And you can never know this, because it's a lot of details, so you have to work your way through there. Second thing is the character. And also, you know, you discover something about the character, then you write it, you write back, you go back and you rewrite some stuff for it to be deeper, more interesting, and sometimes to plant some seeds for twists, you know, that are about to come. So it's Sisyphic. How do you say Sisyphic in English?
Effort.
Yeah, I read that you learned how to speak Farsi, the Farsi language, in order to direct some of your actors and tell this story. What would you want people to learn about Iranian culture that you picked up on as you were working on this project?
Well, I have to tell you, I didn't know much about Iran before I started working on Tehran. And working on Tehran, learning Farsi, I learned about a really deep, amazing culture, full of poetry, amazing cinema. I found that the Iranians are one of the most literate people on earth. People love reading there in Iran, and there's almost no analphabets in Iran. And also, what I really learned was really interesting was about the young people of Iran. So we started watching TV shows and the movies from Iran, and just regular YouTube clips of young people, I found out that there's a whole culture of skaters in Iran, something you would never imagine, or people who go out to raves in the desert to listen to Western music. And this is something I would love to people to learn about Iran. And we showed it, we used all of those elements to create our thriller. So, you know, it's not a National Geographic show. It's an espionage thriller, but, you know, watching it, you learn so much stuff about Iran, and I would say about human nature too.
Yeah, that's awesome. Mm-hmm. When you are working on a show that will be streaming, kind of think about your future projects. Does that open up the creative field creatively, instead of doing maybe something for basic cable or network shows?
You know, I think that it's a huge privilege to know that we are streamed worldwide. I would say this is the most amazing thing. And you understand suddenly that you, especially living in Israel, that you can talk to a really wide audience. And I think that this story, Tehran, is a story that really can relate to anyone, because it's a story about a young girl going to an enemy country and having to face her deepest fears and having to falling in love and not knowing will she succeed to stay alive, to fulfill her mission. And this is something that I'm sure talks, you know, to anybody from Europe, Asia, Africa, well, you know, and the United States, of course.
Well, I mean, definitely, I think there's a lot of relatable elements to this show, for sure. And it's just it's a fun ride, for sure. So thank you so much. It's been great talking to you today. I've learned a lot talking to you today about Tehran.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you. You too. Did you watch all those movies?
I've not seen all of them yet, but I've seen a lot of them.
I'm sure you did.
Yeah. Take care.
Bye-bye.